journey back in time. No human eye has ever seen this land or the extraordinary creatures that roam here. A land discovered thousands of years before Columbus.
A world of bizarre creatures ruled by the deadliest aerial predator since the time of the dinosaurs. It's like a Hitchcock horror.
Look into the past, and you will see a battle between humankind and beasts that rages for thousands of years. This is the story of how we first ventured into an alien world and met monstrous beasts. It is our own epic about our journeys in lost lands and the monsters we met there. Ancient giants are gone. They could not stand against the human advance. The struggle has come to an end, and we have won. And a land of lost monsters is now our legacy. In just a few decades, the precious food source was becoming scarce, and desperate measures were used to drive the last moas out of their forest retreats. Whirlwinds of fire snaked through the bush, turning a refuge into an inferno. Humans have used fire to bring down big game before, but this time, the fire we unleash might consume us as well. And so it is that the mammoth is not a part of our world, or the saber-toothed cat, or the giant American lion. These monsters are now only ghosts. Are we at all haunted by their loss?
Easter Island, the remotest scrap of land on Earth, lost in the Pacific Ocean. Here, proud monoliths lie in neglect, abandoned by a Polynesian society in ruins. The forests felled, the birds gone, the soil eroded by farming and the wind. When the Polynesians arrived here in 400 AD, the island was covered in dense forest. Steadily, it was cleared to plant great gardens, build canoes, and erect these magnificent statues. Within 1,000 years, a culture that created the only written Polynesian language vanished, collapsing into warfare, cannibalism, and environmental ruins. Here is the paradox of humans. We are capable of such heroic and triumphant creation, and yet we are also highly capable of perpetrating such horror on the rest of the natural world. Smoking gun is in our hands. Somewhere in our battle for survival, we acquired the power to cause extinction.